Attention, everyone.
Ladies and gentlemen of G-Fest, don't make Megumi Odaka have to use her psychic powers to know how much you're happy that she is here. To be up here with Miss Odaka, and of course Robert Scottfield, who is going to be translating for us. I would love to start talking a little bit about your early life. I know you and I are actually almost the same age, and you were born in Kanagawa. How did you move from Kanagawa into the entertainment business?
When I was 14 years old, Toho had a Cinderella contest. And she entered the contest and she won the contest. So she became a new face at the Toho Studios.
Was this before, this must have been before Princess from the Moon, Taketori Monogatari?
Yes.
So when did you get picked up from Toho into working that film?
もうあのそのシンデレラ東宝シンデレラコンテストのオーディション内容にそのコンテストに受かった方は同時に市川崑監督の竹取物語という日本最古の物語にオリジナル出演するっていうのは約束事として決まっていたので出演しました。
The deal was that anyone who won the Cinderella contest were then contracted out to be in the first movie. So it was part of having winning the contest that they would be connected directly to the next movie that they were going to do. And that's how she got into the movie. The
There's
a famous actress who won the very first one. She was the winner of the second Cinderella contest. And so she was the winner of the second one, yeah.
So the movie I mentioned, Princess from the Moon, it's a classic Japanese tale, also known as the Tale of the Bamboo Cutter. And Odaka-san played Akeno, the blind nanny, and she actually won an Academy Award for it in 1988 for a new actor award.
Exactly, that's the part that she did play, and at that time she also, like with Miki and Irumas, she had the power of her brain that she could use. And even though she couldn't see, she could smell a flower and tell the color of it in the movie. And so she was there as a friend for the princess, and that's where things started. And yes, she ended up winning the Academy Award for that. So I'll give her another hand for that. Mr. Mifune was also the father of the princess in that same movie, so everybody knows Mr. Mifune. Yeah, yeah,
もちろん.
Yeah. Yeah, do you know Mr. Mifune? Yeah.
It's also directed by a very famous director as well. Kong Ichikawa. You guys familiar with that name? Very, very.
He was the director of that movie as well. So they had a superstar lineup, that whole thing.
So after Princess from the Moon, you found yourself working in television a little bit. Can you tell us a little bit about Hana no Asukumi, which is a delinquent girl comic? It was a manga that was turned into a live-action television series, and Megumi Odaka played like the lead character.
Hi, I'm 15.
That's what Jubo said. Oh, I'm trying to do it in Japanese. Okay. Actually,
Jubo さんの時にテレビドラマの花のアスカ組という番組がありまして、それで私ロングヘアだったんですけど、撮影のシーンでレディショートに髪を切るっていう役があって、で、不良の女の子の役でケンカをする時にコインを
When I was 15 years old is when they started the TV series, and it's basically, it's a girl on the wild side basically, and whenever she got in a fight she had a coin that she'd flip and throw at people. But she was there for the good cause basically, so she, even though she was on the wild side, it was always for the cause of the good side. She was one of the good sides, but that was the TV program that she was on, yes. Mm.
How long was it between that television program and you being hired for Godzilla vs. Biodante?
So she was just on the TV program for a year, and 1 year later, Godzilla came. Wow.
How did you feel about getting asked to be part of the sort of resurgence of the Godzilla series?
Of course, she didn't really understand Godzilla at the time, but the as it was a resurgence as well, one of the stars from the first movie that she was in was also in the last Godzilla movie of the last series. And so when she heard that the superstar lady was in the movie before and that they were going to have a resurgence, she went to the video place, rented out the last one that there, and she looked at it and said, oh wow, this is going to be something huge. And because she was basically a new face for the Godzilla series as well, she wanted to go say hello to everyone and give her greetings, and she was watching the special effects, and she could see Satsuma getting into his outfit and getting in, and he has this aura around him as the Godzilla, the aura, and she wanted to go say hi to him, but she was kind of scared, so she kind of looked at him from way behind and said, yeah, wow, this is really big. Yeah.
So tell us a little bit about your experience working on that film. You were a brand new character, and I'm assuming at that time you did not know that your character was going to continue past that film.
まず関西空港のヘリポート、あの時の撮影の時に ヘリコプター飛んでるだけで、あと誰もいなくて、周りのスタッフ、あれがゴジラだと思って、大森監督から、あのヘリはゴジラだと思って、ずっとテレパシーを送っててくださいって言って、何時間も何時間もずっとやって、はい、で試写会を見初めて見た時にびっくりしました。
びっくりしました means very surprised, butas you're acting, you don't actually get to see Godzilla in front of you. And so when she was in the teleport, going up in the helicopter, going across the ocean, and she has to look out with her teleport, she says, Godzilla, this is Godzilla, Godzilla here and everything else. And she'd done it many, many times for the scenes. And she finally, when she was at the previews, she finally got to see herself and see Godzilla actually coming out and said, he really is there!
あの、ゆみちゃんすごくいい役だったな、やって
たじゃない。 Everybody around me says, you really got a good part in this movie!
So aside from actually Godzilla, you are the only character in the Godzilla films to really haveThe same character through a whole bunch of movies. You had a continuity
about you. ゴジラだ、ゴジラ vs ビオランテの後のゴジラ対あ vs ビオキングギドラですか？一緒にやった。あの時は成長してなきゃいけないんですよ。衣装かなんかやったんだけど、あの。ちょっと大人っぽくというか、だけど、メガゴジラだったじゃない？時からは今度、ゴジラとベビーとか、そっち、はい、その、話が変わっちゃうもしないけど、自分の中、私の小高としての心情が演じるにあたっては、メカゴジラから、その、ゴジラに対する共存していく生物としての地球で成長して、どうしていくための生命体として、なんとかゴジラとこう一緒に生きていくことはできないのか、ゴジラを倒すことを考えないでベビーをまず守りながらベビーが出てきたことによって、そういうふうに変化して6作に行きました。
The Biollante was the first one, and then the one that we were in together, Godzilla vs. King Ghidorah, at that time, she felt like she had to grow up a little more. She was trying to become more of an adult in the movie that we were in together. But after that, when the baby Godzilla came out, and instead of trying to get, rid of Godzilla and the telepathy that she had, if there was any way that she could use her powers to help,find a way that human beings and Godzilla could live together, especially to protect the baby. And she thinks that that's probably one of the big main points in the movie, and probably one of the reasons why she was able to be in so many of them, because it's actually something that happens in life all the time, trying to coexist with other people and other things. You should give her a hand for that.
ベビーのおとりになってコンテナに入っていくんですよ。ゴジラを悟るために、あのベビーをおとりに使うのに、その私はそれ後追いかける顔のシーンがあるんですけど、あそこがあのシーンが大好きですね。
She likes the scene, especially when they're asking the baby to come out, and she's actually following the baby and sees him heading towards, I think it's got the...
本当違う、ベビーゴジラと主演の佐野涼子ちゃん演じる五条あずさの女の子がコンテナの中に入るで運ばれていくのを私が追いかけるところだったんですけど、そこのシーンが大好きです。
There's a part when one of the other actresses has baby Godzilla, they get in something that they're taking off, and she's following them, she's chasing after them. That's one of her favorite scenes in all of the movies.
Do you really like baby Godzilla?Still today?
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Little Godzilla, Junior.
Your friends, right?
Yes. Telepath.
Yes. So, what was it like actually filming on the first camera unit, not interacting with the special effects units? And you had to imagine where Godzilla was.
Godzilla was in the
もうこうやったらディオランテの試写会を見た時点でこれはいつもゴジラはそんなつもりで撮ってももちろん思ってなかったんですけれども 特撮班に川北班に負けちゃいられないっていうんで 1時間 45分の映画の中に 本編アクトレスアクターのは 40分間だけなの 3ヶ月かけてやるんですけど 初めての出演する人に出演する俳優さんたちには小高君のリアクションはオーバーだっていうのね。だけどこれぐらいやってちょうどいいんですって言って中尾家さんという俳優さんも他のお役者さんから初めて参加する役者さんにとってはなんかオイズオーバーアクションって言うんだけど、いやいや何本も出てるって君たちも分かるからって言って初めてやっぱりその方たちも見た時に
After doing Biolanta the first time, of course, there's nothing in front of you, but after seeing that movie, she realized that she would have to imagine it even more. The one thing that some of the other actresses, actors in the movie said when they were filming just the part for the actors without Godzilla, is that you're overacting, you're doing too much. And she'd say, no, after you've been in a movie at least one, you'll realize this is just perfect. And so she and one other actor, they acted about the same level, and the other actors considered them overacting, but when they actually saw the end process, they said, perfect. And we didn't want to lose to Kawakita or to Godzilla. As actors, we wanted to be number one!
So out of the Heisei era movies that you were in, Biolante, Biolante, through Destoroyah, do you have a favorite of those performances?
The movie she likes the best, of course, is Godzilla vs. King Ghidorah! Yeah! But the movie, the one she liked the best with her acting was actually The Destroyer, so yeah.
Is it okay if she talks a little bit about the making of King Ghidorah?
Please. You all want to hear that, right?
Anna Nakagawa is a very nice person, and during the breaks between shoots, they would be waiting and sitting somewhere talking, and they'd be talking about everything, going out to eat together and stuff like that, and she'd say, oh, those really cute earrings you have on those bridges. Oh, okay, I'll give them to you. Whoa, no, oh, yeah, here you go, oh, yeah. Back and
forth.
Sasaki Kazuhiko, yeah, the scientist in the movie, yeah, Mr. Sasaki, yeah.
が 私とアンナちゃんを寿司屋に連れてってくれたことがあって、お寿司を食べに連れてってくれた時にすっごく美味しくて看板も出てないようなもう、なんかシークレット寿司屋みたいなところなんですけれども、でそこで食べた瞬間にアンナちゃんとバッて目が合って言葉にできない。で佐々木さんにその後京都の時代劇の現場であったんですね、テレビドラマの。 で、佐々木さん、寿司屋連れてって私会ったのって言ったら、もうその寿司屋今やってない。残念。でも私の今まで
In the day, Mr. Sasaki, who plays the scientist in Godzilla as King Ghidorah as well. He was here a few years ago as well, too, with Aisan. Yeah. And he loved to go to different places to eat. There's this great sushi place, and he took Megumi and Anna to that place. And as the three of them were eating, they took a big bite of a menu that is not on the menu. They actually, because he goes there a lot, he's asked for certain things that are not on the menu. And Megumi and Anna took a bite, and they look at each other, and they go, wow. They didn't have words, it was so delicious. And so they got to Kyoto, this was actually in Kyoto when they were filming for this, and where the sushi bar was. And after a few years they went back, and Mr. Sasaki was in one of those jidaigekis, the samurai type of movies. And they both were there and says, take us to the sushi place again. Okay, and they looked into it, there was no more sushi place. So they didn't go again, so she says, it's the best sushi I've ever had in my whole life.
残念だ. Do you want to talk a little bit more about
it was a little fun. Just to add to that, Mr. Sasaki, myself, Anna, and Megumi, the four of us, we would always be sitting somewhere. Who's the other guy in the movie's name? I can't get his name. The actor, the reporter, the guy who wrote the book. He was also in Mr. Baseball. Anyway, that's how much I remember him. Yeah, anyway. He was there. He was actually new to the business as well. And I was new to it, but I was just having a good time. But he was new to it. He wouldn't come over and talk to us. So it was always Mr. Sasaki, myself, and Megumi-chan and Anna. And the four of us would be talking about everything. I didn't ask for any pierced earrings, of course. But we were talking about all kinds of stuff. And I mean, it was just so much fun. And Mr. Omori is actually from Kyoto. Lives in the Kansai, Osaka, in the Kobe area, and so we got along really well, having been on a radio program together, so we all really hit it off. And so even after the movies were over, we always connect to each other, and if they were, she was in a lot of plays, Fiddler on the Roof, all kinds of things she did, so I'd go see her plays. Anna was in plays as well, so we kept in touch a lot. So, she's got a picture of the two of us when I went to see her. See, that's how close we are! This is great! I felt bad for getting money for having so much fun, you know. No, I didn't feel bad about it, but it was a lot of fun. I remember people talking about having to wait so long, the actors, and I think actors are overrated if they think it's hard to work in that sense. Having to play a role is probably hard, but the waiting is really hard if you got good people around you. So we had a really good time.
That's awesome.
Yeah. Cool.
Anna has since gone to heaven as well, and other people, but if you look at the movie, especially Godzilla vs. King Ghidorah, she's kind of getting choked up here, and she's going to make me choke up too. But Anna has since gone to heaven, but if you look at the movie again, you see her in her happy face and hanging in there in her role. Remember her, and even when I pass on, the next generation of Godzilla fans, they see our movies, if they even remember for a little bit of what we've tried to do to help make Godzilla what it is, we're forever thankful. So thank you very much. As Mr. Murase said in his thing as well, Godzilla is forever. So, yes, let's do that. Did anybody see Shin Godzilla? She wants to tell you that the first scene when he comes out of the ocean, the first stage of Shin Godzilla comes out of the ocean, my house is 3 minutes from that place. It's been rebuilt since, or are things okay? So.
走ってたら一番メインストリートが入れないんですよ。なんでって言ったらノーノーノーって言われて、なになにって言って、ご主人が撮ってるからあんた入っちゃダメよって言われて、
I can't believe it, but she was on her bicycle going and running some errands on her way back, and all of a sudden she couldn't get to this main street that she always goes down to go shopping. She said, "What? Why can't I get through the street? We're making a Godzilla movie right now, so you can't come in." Nikki cannot come in.
Come on.
But I wanted to be, at least become an extra and run away from the Shin Godzilla! And if, and after she, the scene, she was able to go through the street, and the different shops you go in, they were giving away little tickets and things. If you got a certain amount of tickets, they would give you something for the tickets. And so all these old ladies were giving her these things. She goes, "Wow, thank you so much. Thank you so much. Wait a minute, I was in all these Godzilla movies. What's going on here?"
So you, did you enjoy Shin Godzilla? Just out of curiosity?
I liked it very much. Her husband is also here as well, but her father-in-law, she went to see the 2014 American Godzilla together with her husband and father-in-law. And when they went there, Watanabe Ken was in it as well. And when he's almost 90 years old now, the father-in-law, when he opened the pamphlet and looked, saw Watanabe Ken and all the names and now that it's in Hollywood and this and that, he looked over at Megumi and says, "You know, you're really something after all." My father-in-law really didn't know me up to this point.
Okay, let's go back and talk a little bit more about the Heisei era. Obviously, you were in all of those movies after the first 1984 film. So, from Vigilante to Destroya, did you have any stories that you'd like to tell us about working with specific actors, maybe some of the Showa era actors? You were in King Ghidorah with Yoshio Tsuchiya.
She has a lot more experience and memories with Kawakita. Is it okay if she talks about him?
いろいろな山下健二郎監督、大森監督、大河原監督、皆さんとそのキャンペーンで
After the movie is finished filming, of course you have to go out on the streets to the different theaters, and they have previews, and they get the actors and actresses come out, and they give their greetings and stuff, talk a little bit about the movie, and then you see the movie. And so, having been on so many movies, she's dealt with different directors as well, and that's one of the memories that she has.
だけど、ここから初日、ずらっと並んでるファンの方の前で、私たち金屏風の前でこうやって待って、今日ありがとうございますとか着物を着てやってるんだけど、全員ファンの子は、まず川北監督に握手を求めに行って、本編の俳優陣の前をすぐ、ゴジラと川北監督にしかいない。The
one thing. One thing I was really upset about, I'm the actress in the movie, but everybody knew Mr. Kawakita as the special effects of Godzilla. And so even at the previews, the actors, I was in my nice kimono, ready to greet all the fans, and most of the fans walked right in front of me to go over and shake the hand of Kawakita! In all six of the movies, I was in. But it was really a lot of fun. Yeah. During those times, I only was in one movie, but they put me in a male kimono as well. And I have to put some, I'll find some pictures to stick them on Facebook or something, but we were all much younger, of course, and we had all the directors there and the actors, and we were always talking about, again, just a lot of fun. And they made me wear these wooden bamboo or wooden sandals, and you don't want to ever do that to yourself. I don't know how they moved around so well, because that's hurt like a bugger, you know. In the middle of your, inside of your toes are hurting for about 2 weeks. It's like riding a horse for about 5 hours, you know. Your legs hurt, but it just hurt like crazy. But the kimono was really nice. All the previews were really nice. One thing I remember mostly, some of the previews, you'd see the movie first, and then we would come out, and we got a bigger applause. The one I remember, we got up on the stage first and talked, and then they saw the movie, and so we're there in the preview, no one's seen anything. They're looking at me going, who is this guy? Who is this guy? Kind of looks like Bruce Willis. Well, no, that's not Bruce Willis. Or something like that. But yeah, Die Hard? No, he's not here. But anyway, and so they saw that, and they were just kind of looking at me, man, who is this guy? You know, and when it was all over, and they saw what Emily actually did, then everybody had applauded. So I liked them watching the movie first, and then me coming out. It was a lot better that way, so.
It builds your, in your character, for sure.
ちょうど5時だと、ベガギラは戦いに新宿ステーションでバーンっていうところ本番見てたんですよ。そしたらカメリハのダイヤで、カメリハのカメラリハーサルの時に、キングギラのワイヤーが切れちゃって、新宿の街がもうぐちゃぐちゃになっちゃって、で、もうスタッフでに合わないになっちゃって、で、川北監督が2日でなんとかしろって言って、それでもう2日後にはもうちゃんと。
If you've ever been in the Toho studio, some of you have, the most famous studios are number 8 and number 9. And number 8 and number 9 are, they have the actors acting in one and they have the special effects in the other one. They're very close to each other. So myself and Megumi would also, when we had time, we'd walk over and watch the special effects. And during the filming of Godzilla vs. King Ghidorah, they had Godzilla facing Mecha King Ghidorah in one scene that she went to watch. And as they were practicing the rehearsal, the piano wires above broke and smashed right into the train station at the bottom of the miniatures. And if you've ever seen one of those miniatures, it takes them a lot of time to put one together. So they try to make everything, they plan everything perfect. They try to get just one cut because they're going to smash all the miniatures. But it fell from the piano wire, smashed all the things, and Kawakita stood up very quietly and says, I want it all taken care of in 2 days. Remake it in 2 days. 2 days later, she went to watch again, and it was done in 2 days. I I realize that doing special effects is also a very hard job.
Space Ocean の時も
When they were filming in Okinawa as well for some of the scenes of Space Godzilla, the ocean was very beautiful and it looked really nice. The staff were in the ocean all day long filming, and I was just waiting to say, wow, this is great, I can finally go swimming in the ocean. And some of the staff came up there and said, you can't get sunburned, so you can't go in the ocean. What? So she never got in the windy, beautiful ocean.
あの、橋で弾き出しました。演じる役に戦うことしか男の人戦うことしか考えてないのっていうセリフがあるんだけど、あそこの雰囲気作りがなかなかできなくて、山下健二監督がすごいボリュームでこんな大きいスピーカーでイメージソングをかけてくれて、その中で役作りをやらせていただいたのはありがたかったです。
One scene that was on the right next to the ocean, we're on the beach, can't get beach out of my mouth. Right on the beach, and they were trying to, there's one line that says, all you're thinking about is fighting, and they're saying it in Japanese, of course, but the direct translation is, are you just thinking about fighting? That's all you're thinking about? They just couldn't get in the right mood, and they couldn't get, the director didn't like exactly what was happening. So what he did was, so that they could get better at their that one scene, he pulled in a huge speaker and he cranked up a fight song. So a Japanese fight song until they could get in the mood, and they finally got the scene the way that the director wanted. Yamashita Kenshiro, the director, yeah. And so then, but they finally got the scene that they wanted because of this great big speaker, the fight song, whatever the fight song was. You know.
In Space Godzilla, I feel like your character actually got to evolve a little bit more, got to do a little bit more outside of just being sort of the psychic connection to Godzilla. You actually were able to act and have a love scene, or not a love scene, but a romantic interest.
初の2つのロマンスの初恋のシーンもありましたし、恋をつなぐことなんですけれども、テレパシーの話とラブロマンスの2つの話をすると、まずテレパシーの話は、相手に自分の見えているものを見せてあげる、今ベビーがこういう状態だっていうのを、主役の橋爪純さんにしてあげるラストシーンです。
As you just said, she basically had, it's the same person, but she basically had two different parts of her coming out in Space Godzilla. The telepathy part where she would explain what Baby Godzilla was doing and try to explain to everybody what he was thinking, etc. Yeah. Closing your eyes. Yeah. And then?
Yamashita 小指をつないでくださいっていうのね。で、はい、はい。スタートって言われて、一気にトコトコトコトコって歩いてて、ピッて小指でつないだの。カットっつったらスタッフ全員大爆笑して、なんで笑われたかわからなくて、えみちゃん小指をつなぐっていうのはこうやってつなぐんじゃないよ、こうだよっていうの。でも私は小指をつなぐってこうだと思ったけど、気づいてたのありました。すごい恥ずかしかった。みんな下手に思われちゃう。
And the other Megumi is her first love, and the one scene that she, Mickey, her husband's here, we gotta be careful, yeah. There he is, I'm sorry, yeah. But Mickey in the movie, she's falling in love for the first time, and the funny thing about this scene was, is the director says, okay, I want you to walk up, and in Japan, they take their pinkies and they put them, it's kind of a love thing, it's kind of put their fingers, and there's a certain way to do it. And when they said ready action, she walked up and she grabbed his pinky with her pinky, and then he said cut, and all the staff started breaking out in laughter. He said, wonder why? Well, because you must be your first time you fall in love because you're not doing the pinky thing right. And everybody's just laughing and loving it. I felt sort of embarrassed.
And
please watch the movie. You'll notice that she's in the bed. She's being held out with the bed's moving this and that. She's able to use a lot more telepathy in the movie as well. She's gotten a lot stronger in Space Godzilla.
Yeah, and then in the last Godzilla film you were in, Destoroyah, you also had another psychic friend that you worked with. Can you tell us a little bit about acting with your co-host, your co-star? Too many podcasts.
Mabel, Osawa Sayaka-chan, actress. But my friend.
They're friends from before, so it's very easy to work with her, yeah. Cool. Sayaka is her name, yeah. And they're from the same agency, too. And we're only 1 year difference between the two of us, so we're very close. So we always go out to eat together, and we exchange pierced earrings together. No. Going back to the other story. But so we were very close from the very beginning, so it was very easy to work with her. And when she first received the script for Destroyer, it says Godzilla Shisu, which means Godzilla dies. It basically is the title in Japanese. And she said, well, if Godzilla dies, I'm connected to him, so I guess I'm going to die as well. And she's reading through the script. She said, wait a minute, only Godzilla's dying and I'm not going to die? So she actually felt bad about staying alive when Godzilla's actually dying. So, yeah.
私も高知桃子さん初代1回のゴジラの時にヒロインをやった高知桃子さんがデストロイヤーでもう1回出てるの知ってる人いたの知ってる40年後出てるんだけど、だからあと2、30年したらまたゴジラ映画に最後さ見て出させてくださいねって富山プロデューサーと約束してます。
And about 3 years ago, Mr. Tomiyama, who's one of the producers during the Heisei era especially, he put out a book a few years ago. And at the book signing or something, she was there meeting with him. One of the actresses from the Showa era, 40 years later, she was in another Godzilla movie. And so when they're at this book signing, she walked up to him and said, hey, this actress, 40 years later, she was in another Godzilla movie, so I want you to promise me now, 20 or 30 years from now, I'm going to be in another Godzilla movie, okay? Yeah!
Again, like many years from now, would you want to be in another Godzilla film?
Of course!
Of course! She also loves the legendary Godzilla as well, and she loves how Ken Watanabe has played a very good role in that. She's met him many times in a comedy play on TV, actually. And so he's a very nice man. And the last scene where he I forgot the line in English, but he comes up and he says, what's the last line that he says? Godzilla is living, he's a living thing, he's living forever, or
I haven't memorized that movie.
Anyway, it's the last scene, whatever the last line was. She loves that last line of his, and she loves the Godzilla from America as well. So yeah, good. Nice.
goodbye to Godzilla, with the rest of the world, of course. And what you end up doing after 1995's film?
This is kind of the opposite of what most people would do. Most people, they start out as being waiters or waitresses or working at bars and stuff like that and trying to find their chance into the movies or something, become famous. She was the opposite way. From a very young age, she won the Cinderella contest. She became a famous person, was in many movies, many TV dramas, many plays. Once she said sayonara, goodbye to Godzilla, she wanted to try other things. So she worked at a cosmetic company. She worked at a store. She even worked at a Mos Burger, which is kind of like a McDonald's in Japan. She wanted to try a bunch of different things. And she said in her 30s, she had a great time trying things she'd never been able to do before. Wow.
Nice.
Just for your information, this is something that won't be a quiz or anything. The president who started Mos Burger, it doesn't really mean Mos, the stuff that grows on the bottom of the trees. It's M-O-S. And the people who started it wanted to have a big image like America, so they came and looked at McDonald's and Burger King, and Kentucky's already there, but they looked at this big, they wanted a big image. So the meaning of M-O-S is actually Mountain Ocean Sun. Mos Burger. So you need all of them to create food, you need all of them for a big image, and that's where Mos Burger came from. Most Japanese people don't know that, so you're listening to the guy who knows all this stuff. There you go. Yeah, she didn't know either. See? Any job you have that anybody has is hard, but it should be hard because it makes it more interesting. And that's what she thinks. Yeah. She worked for a couple of companies as well when the president was kind of like the demon that we talked about in the last one, the Satsuma. Just really on your case all the time. But when you look back at it, it made you stronger. And that is actually what makes it more fun. You have the challenge to try, challenge yourself, make things better. And even though there are people telling you you're not doing it right, you do get better. And so when you look at it in the long run, everything I've done has been fun. But she started as an actress, and she went into working at Mos Burger later. This is kind of cool. It's just backwards. But I think it's really cool. It's a great way to look at life, too. Yeah.
今はもうこの2、3年はあの、なんて、ファザインが。
For the last 2 or 3 years, she's been taking care of her father-in-law. He's been sick, and she's been having to haul him around all over the place. Yeah. So yeah, very nice of her. But the father-in-law didn't know who Mickey was for a long time. Let him marry the son, and then found out later, you're something else. I just asked her the question, what would you like to do now? And she says, she's going to rip out a list, I think. She's got so many things that she wants to do now. There's just so many things I want to continue to do. And for a while she was sick herself. She's gotten a lot better. For many years she wasn't able to come to these conventions. And so we are very, very lucky to have her. So I really would give her... whether she's in another Godzilla movie, whatever happens, whatever we do in life, gambarimasu, which means you gotta hang in there, you gotta do your thing. So let's all do that. Hang in there.
Thank you, Emilio Daka, for being here.
One more time!